Here we are again. Here we speak, still cooling tower components. This time we are talking about drop separators. The droplet separators, as the word itself says, are elements that are inside the cooling tower. They are positioned above the distribution, so above the nozzles. They are used to stop, therefore, to stop those water droplets that would be carried away by the airflow. In essence, when there is forced ventilation in a tower, the air tends to carry water droplets and transport them outside, thereby increasing water consumption in the process. To reduce water losses, droplet separators are installed. How are they made? Also, like filling packages, the traditional materials are now plastic materials, PVC or polypropylene. The droplet separators that are most commonly used in towers now are thermoformed ones. Another type of droplet separators are continuous and parallel fin droplet separators. They possess slightly lower efficiency. They are mainly used for other droplet separation systems, not for cooling towers, or at least much less on cooling towers. They can still be seen on the old cooling towers, but now they tend to be replaced. In the past, these separators were also made of wood, but it is an outdated construction type that is no longer used. Interested in tower components? Otherwise, let's change the video, huh?